So Aikido is a martial art, often called meditation in motion. We're not learning how to kick or strike or beat somebody into submission, but more importantly, we're learning to blend with that person, to find a harmony with them, not using force against force, but ultimately learning to become one with our ego, not letting our ego get in the way, to see a harmonious resolution with the person. On a physical level, Aikido involves throws, joint locks, and pins to control a person. So we're not trying to beat them up. On a non-physical level, there's a lot deeper connection with the person's energy called ki or chi energy, and being able to connect with them, whether it's a smile or any other interaction.
Of course, in my personal life, there is a very strong connection between diplomacy and Aikido, because whatever time I steal from diplomacy is allocated to Aikido, and whatever time is taken from Aikido, I have to devote to diplomacy. So there is a 24 hours a day, and I have to make a proper balance. I was so lucky being in Washington that I had time to come to Dojo and to practice with the wonderful people here in Washington, D.C. And that was for me a great opportunity and great enjoyment. And at the same time, I spent a full day in the State Department talking to American diplomats, establishing better relation between Poland and U.S., especially in the subject of supporting democracy all over the world. That was the key subject, the strategic dialogue on democracy promotion and democracy support. So here you have your answer. That was the perfect combination between Aikido and diplomacy. Up to the 6 p.m. it was diplomacy, and from the 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. Aikido. It was mid 70s when the movie about Bruce Lee came to the screen. When you are 15 years or 16 years old and you see Bruce Lee, you just feel like this is something awesome. So I started to practice first karate, then judo. But then I read the book about Aikido, and this element of reading people's mind became for me extremely interesting. I wanted to really study what they mean. So I went through the Aikido, but then I discovered when I started to look for the Aikido club in Warsaw that there is no any single club. So there was one, but far from Warsaw. So I started to contact those people there and actually established the first club in Warsaw. My professional life led me to finally be Polish ambassador to Japan, which was about 15 years later when I started Aikido. So this is how diplomacy and Aikido mixed together. So now we have 37 years of the history of Aikido in Poland. Aikido in Poland was the first in the former Soviet bloc. So then we were followed by Czechs, Hungarians, Bulgarians, Romanians, and Russians. Now we have about 250 dojo all over the Poland. So we have maybe 5,000, 6,000, 7,000, depends on the time of their active practitioners. But the people who were practicing and then for some reason stopped and they're coming back, sometimes sending their children now, we are counting up to 70,000, 60,000 of the people who went through Aikido training, either 1 year, 2 years, or 3 years. So they understand what is this, they sympathize with Aikido, sometimes they're coming back.